When the very first military service members arrived in 1940, the conditions they faced were actually not that much better than the work crews from the Work Progress Administration that had preceded them. As a matter of fact, you'll see in the beginning where the surveyors arrived on base, they just had problems getting through it, excavating probably thousands of acre feet of muck and replacing it with sand so that you could actually have a buildable surface. They were constantly under duress of being affected by rattlesnakes and just hordes and hordes of mosquitoes. The housing conditions were really not up to snuff for what they expected to be a premier U.S. air base, the largest construction project to that point in time in the area. Still looked very much like an airfield in the abyss. So they very much had to continue to operate as any good Army soldier would. Throw up a canvas tent, go ahead and start a fire if you want to go ahead and have hot food, for example. Once World War II kicked off in 1941, population mushroomed from 2,000 to 20,000. Therefore, we relied on the local Tampa Bay community to allow service members to have an opportunity to get respite from the nonstop work and the difficult living conditions on the base until everything could finally get constructed in the 1943, 44, 45 timeframe.